Good morning, students. Myself is Jerlin Ajit Davidson, assistant professor from ECE Department of Christian College of Engineering and Technology. Today we are going to revise the topic bus arbitration techniques, the fifth unit of computer architecture. So now let us see what is bus arbitration. So bus arbitration means it is the process of selecting the next bus master, right? So bus master is nothing but which has the it is a device which has control over the bus at that particular time, right? That device is called the bus master, right? So the bus arbitration is the method or technique used to select the next bus master. Right. So while selecting the next bus master, the current bus master will leave the control of the bus and passes the control to the new bus master. So that is what it takes place in the bus arbitration techniques. So next we are going to see the approaches. Right. So before going to see the different approaches in the bus arbitration technique, we are going to discuss about some situation. That is, a situation may arise that at one particular time several devices like controllers or processors may try to access the common bus at the same time, right? So different devices are trying to access the bus at the same time, but access cannot be given to all the devices. Access can be given to only one device at a particular time, right? So at this time a conflict may arise, right? So to resolve these conflicts, bus arbitration procedure is implemented. The bus arbitration procedure coordinates the activities of all devices which are requesting the memory transfers. And while selecting the bus master, so during the selection of the bus master, we should take into account the several parameters like the needs of various devices, like for example the establishing the priority system for gaining the access. So these things all should be taken into account while selecting the bus master, right? So and the device which select the bus master is called the bus arbiter. That is, the bus arbiter decides who should become the next bus master. So there are two approaches in bus arbitration. So the two approaches are centralized bus arbitration technique and distributed bus arbitration technique, right? So the two techniques are entirely different. So that is, in centralized bus arbitration, only one device participate in the selection of the bus master. That is, only one device will perform the required arbitration. But whereas in the case of distributed bus arbitration technique, all devices will participate in the selection of the next bus master. Hence it is called a distributed bus arbitration approach. This is how the distributed bus arbitration technique differs from the centralized bus arbitration approach. So next we are going to discuss the different methods of bus arbitration. So there are three techniques or three bus arbitration method. The first one is daisy chaining method, and the second one is polling method, and the third one is independent request method. So first we are going to see in detail about the daisy chaining method. So the daisy chaining method is a centralized bus arbitration method. So as I already told, in centralized bus arbitration method, Only one device will participate in the selection of the next bus master. So in the center, in this daisy chaining method, the bus master can be any device, that is about the processor or a DMA controller unit which are connected to the bus, right? So in the daisy chaining method is now explained with the help of diagram, the procedure which takes place in the during the daisy chaining method, right? So there are two common lines, bus request and acknowledgement lines, and there are several devices, device 1, device 2 and up to device M. They are there connected to the bus arbiter. So one common line is there for requesting for the bus's access, that is to take control over the bus. The device must send a request to the bus arbiter. That request is called bus request signal. So to take control over the bus, if a device want to take or control over a bus, means it should send a bus request signal BR to the through the common line which is called bus request line or BRQ line, right? So all the devices have the common line to send the bus request. And the bus arbiter in turn what will do means it will send the bus CRAN signal to the corresponding destination, that is to the requested device. The bus how the bus CRAN signal is propagated means it the bus CRAN signal is not directly given to the requested device. It propagates serially through the device 1 and next to the device 2 and next to the device 3 and finally to the requested device. For example, if the device 3 is has requested the bus, means the bus CRAN signal is first sent to the device 1 and then it is propagated to the device 2 and then it finally reaches the device 3. So once the bus CRAN signal is received by the device, so then it means that the device can start the bus trans start the data transfer over the bus, that is it can take control over the bus and also it can make the data transfer over the bus. So this acknowledgement is used to say send the acknowledgement, that is the device has received the bus CRAN signal. That is, this line is used by the device to send the acknowledgement signal. That is, it has received the bus CRAN signal like that, right? So through this, they are sending the acknowledgement signal for the bus CRAN signal, right? So this is the what daisy chaining method, right? So now let us see the advantages in the daisy chaining method. So and this daisy chaining method is very simple, and that is we call this simple and scalability. Scalability means we can easily configure, right? So the user can add more devices anywhere along the chain, right? So that is called we can easily configure this device, or we can easily modify this the devices, right? The user can add more devices anywhere along the chain. That is called easy configuration. And disadvantages. The disadvantages here is the priority for a device depends on the position of the bus master, right? So for the priority for a particular device depends on the its position, so where it is located. And next is propagation delay arises in this method. So how the propagation delay arises means the propagation of bus CRAN signal, right? So the bus CRAN signal does not directly given to the requested device, whereas it propagates through serially through all the devices and then reaches the requested device. So hence there exists a propagation delay. And the third one is the one of the most important disadvantage, that is, if any one device in that system fails, then the entire system will stop working. That is how means, because the bus, all the devices will take part in the in propagating the bus grant signal towards the requested device. So if any one of the device in between fails, then the bus grant signal does not reach the requested device. Hence, that if any device fails, then the entire system will stop working. The next one is polling method. In this polling method, the devices are assigned unique priorities. That is, they have given unique, that is, same priorities to access, to take access over the bus or to take control over the bus. But the these priorities are dynamically changed to give every device an opportunity. That is, every device which are connected to the system has given opportunity. That is, so we call this polling method as rotating priority method. All the devices which are participated in the connected to the system has given priority dynamically. It is changed. They have given chances to take access over the bus. So that is called polling method. So the diagram for the polling method is given here. So the diagram, as I told, bus request, the purpose of the bus request line, it is used to send the request for the bus. So that is, to take control over the bus, it will send the request. So in this polling method, what is the difference means? That is, priority are dynamically changed. Each device will given an opportunity to take part in the to take control over the bus, right? And the next, the advantages in the polling method is that it does not favor any particular device or processor, right? So that means, I already told that all the devices are given unique priorities. So as that is equal priorities, all the devices has given equal priorities. Hence, it does not favor for any device or processor. And this method is also a simple method. And the advantages, the important point, important advantage is that if one device fails, the entire system will not stop working in the case of polling method. Whereas in the first method, daisy chaining method, if any system, any device fails, the entire system will stop working. But in the case of polling method, if one device fails, then the entire system will not stop working. That is the main advantage of the polling method. Next, we are going to see the third method and the last method of bus arbitration technique. The third method is independent request method, right? So in this method, the bus control passes from one device to another only through the centralized bus arbiter. Right. So while seeing the diagram, we will be able to understand that what is independent request method. And here, each bus master has their separate bus request and bus grant signals. In the earlier two methods, we have seen a common bus request signal, right? A common bus request signal for all the devices. But here in this case, if there are m devices, means there will be m bus request signals and there will be m bus grant signals. That is, each master will have their separate bus request and bus grant signals. So hence it is called an independent request method, right? So this is the diagram for the independent request method. So this independent request method is also called fixed priority bus arbitration method, right? So as I told, that is, each device will have their separate bus request and bus grant signals. See, in the diagram we are able to see the device one will have is having the its separate bus request and bus grant signal, and the device two is having the separate bus request and bus grant signal. Likewise, all the devices will have their separate bus request and bus grant signal, right? So this is, in this way, this independent request method will differ from all other two methods, right? And now we are going to see the advantages and disadvantages of the independent request method. So here, since all the devices have their own bus request and bus grant signals, the response will be faster. That is, the response time is very fast. And the disadvantage is that hardware cost is high, right? So the hardware cost is high. The reason is that there are large number of control lines. Large number of control lines, in the sense, that is, each device has their own bus request and bus grant signals. That is, each device has two lines. Suppose if there are 10 devices, means there will be 20 control lines are there. If there are 20 devices, means there will be 40 control lines. So to establish these connections and all, the cost, the establishment cost will be high, because all the devices have their separate bus request and bus grant signal. So because of this reason, there are large number of control lines are there. So this is the only disadvantage in the independent request method. The hardware cost is high. So thus we have seen all the different techniques and the different approaches in the bus arbitration, right? So bus arbitration means it is the process of selecting the new bus master, and also we have seen the different methods, daisy chaining method, polling method, and the independent request method. And I have seen in detail about how the three methods differ from each other, and we have also seen the advantages and disadvantages of the other three methods. So that's all about the bus arbitration techniques. Thank you, students.